Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about configuring a backend using S3 and Dynamodb with state locking. I have the following agenda for today's video. Firstly, we will understand what exactly is a state file. Then we will learn what is a backend and various types of backend supported by Terraform. And then we will try to understand why do we require a standard backend and what purpose it serves. Next, we will see what is state file locking and why it is required. And finally, we will see everything in action. Now let's see what is a Terraform state file. Terraform must store state about your managed infrastructure and configuration. This state is stored by default in a local file named terraform.tfstate, but it can also be stored remotely, which works better in a team environment. The primary purpose of Terraform state is to store bindings between object in a remote system and resource instances declared in your configuration. While the format of the state files are just JSON, direct file editing of the state is discouraged. Terraform uses the state to create plans and make changes to your infrastructure. Prior to any operation, Terraform does a refresh to update the state with the real infrastructure. So we learnt about Terraform state. Now let's understand what is a backend. Each Terraform configuration can specify a backend which defines where and how operations are performed and where the state snapshots are stored. Primarily, there are two types of backends, enhanced and standard. Enhanced backends are further divided into local and remote, and backends like S3 falls into standard category. When you initiate a Terraform project, the default backend is local unless you explicitly configure any other backend. The backend properties and configuration is defined by the backend block, like I have shown in the snapshot on the right hand side. Local backend will suffice only if you are lone infrastructure developer in your company or the organization, but when the team size grows, you require the state to be stored somewhere externally so that each and every infra developer will get access to the latest copy of the state file. Even though you have externalized your state file, if you are working in a team environment, there are high chances that you will step onto each other's infrastructure. To avoid this scenario, locking is required. If supported by your backend, Terraform will lock your state for all operations that could write state. This prevents others from acquiring the log and potentially corrupting your state file. State file locking on S3 backend can be achieved with Dynamodb table. So the Dynamodb table will hold the information of the log and prevent others to make changes to the infrastructure. Now that we have seen everything in theory, let's jump into the demo. We will first validate whether AWS CLI and Terraform is installed. Once that is done, we will configure the AWS account. I've already done that. You can do the same using AWS configure command and validate it using AWS configure list. Once the AWS CLI is configured, we will copy the provider configuration from the Terraform documentation and add the same in provider.tf. I will share the link in the description below. Since we are going to deploy the infrastructure in Oregon region, we will specify the region as US West 2. In the main.tf, we will define the actual resource. In this case, we are going to create a VPC. In the variables.tf file, we will declare the variables VPC CIDR and the name tag that we have to pass in the main.tf file. The terraform.tf vars file will hold the exact definition of the variables that we will eventually pass in the main.tf. And finally, output.tf file will have the VPC ID which will be created by the Terraform, which can be later consumed by any other resource. This is more or less the basic folder structure of our Terraform project. Once the basic Terraform project is set up with the required configuration, we will run the Terraform init to initialize our project with the specified provider information. As soon as you run the init command, you can see that it is initializing the backend. In this case, the backend is local as we have not explicitly specified any other backend. Apart from that, it is also downloading the AWS provider plugins from the internet. Once the init is run successfully, you see the message in green that the Terraform has been successfully initialized. In the project folder, you will notice that a hidden directory .terraform is created, which will contain all the provider information and the plugins. There is also .terraform.log.hcl file created to record the provider selections made. After the init step, we will proceed with the plan step to generate a plan for the to-be-provisioned infrastructure. You can see that there is one to add, that is our VPC, zero to change and zero to destroy. Let's quickly clear the terminal and run the Terraform apply command. You can again see that there is one to add, that is our VPC, zero to change and zero to destroy. And in the output section, you can see the VPC ID, which will be generated after we run the apply command. So let's enter yes. Now we can see that VPC is being created. Once the apply is successful, we can see the apply complete, resource 1 added, 0 changed and destroyed. Apart from that, we can also see the VPC ID which was defined in the outputs.tf file. Now let's jump into the console and check whether the VPC is created as expected. We can see the name of the VPC is terraform-demo-vpc and the VPC CIDR is 10.0.0.0/16, which was set in the terraforms.tfvars file. So now we have created the VPC using Terraform. However, our state file resides in the local directory. Let's search for Terraform S3 backend for the implementation documentation. Copy the example configuration from the documentation and create a new file in the Terraform folder named backend.tf and paste it. You can see that it requires a bucket, key, and region parameters. Let's quickly go to our S3 console and start creating a new bucket. I am naming my bucket as terraform-ajit-s3-backend-demo-bucket. Keep the region as Oregon, enable bucket versioning and server-side encryption, and hit the Create Bucket button. Now update the Terraform backend configuration with the newly created bucket. Key can be any path with state file. I am putting terraform.tf state and updated the region as US West 2. Since we have changed the backend configuration to store the state file in S3 bucket, we will need to initialize the Terraform project again. Enter yes. Now you can see that it has configured the backend successfully. Let's quickly validate whether it has created the terraform.ts state file in the S3 bucket and open the file to see the contents. We have implemented the S3 backend, however the locking mechanism is yet to be established. Open the documentation and scroll to DynamoDB state locking section. We have to create a DynamoDB table with lock ID as a primary key. Go to tables, create table. I'm giving the name as terraform-ajit-s3-backend-demo-table and partition key as lock ID. Keep rest of the settings as is and create table. In the backend configuration, add the parameter dynamodb_table and enter the name given while creating the table. Since we have made the changes to backend config, we will need to initialize the project again. Now you will notice that the init command has not worked right away. So we have to run the init command with reconfigure argument. Now you can see the initialization is successful. To test the locking functionality, let's make a change to the resource. I am changing the VPC name tag a little and run the Terraform apply command. If you notice, it says acquiring state lock. This may take a few moments. Once the apply is successful, you can see that there is an entry in the DynamoDB table with the corresponding digest value. Let's apply command again and try to see what happens to the DynamoDB table. Now we can see two entries, one ending with terraform.tfstate-digest and the other one with terraform.tfstate, which contains all the information regarding your client. This entry will be deleted as soon as the Terraform apply command is complete. As expected, on clicking that entry, we are getting requested item cannot be found error because the apply is complete and it is releasing the lock. And this is how locking is implemented in Terraform.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel.